If you're like me, then you wouldn't let any married, middle-aged man walking around in Times Square in women's clothing watch your children, right? I mean, you're the kind of person who wants to develop some proof, see logical steps, for instance. And I'm here to tell you that if there are two things that you believe, like this thing, the classic, if you believe that delta x is initial velocity times time plus 1/2 acceleration times time square, and you believe one other thing, all I need is, you just have to believe one other thing. You have to believe the definition of acceleration, that is that acceleration causes velocity changes. So you can go from some velocity to some other velocity when there is an acceleration. If you believe those two equations, then I can get you a brand new equation. And we all know that means more babysitters. So take this equation, this one right here, and solve it for t. So I'm going to subtract this from both sides. I'm going to divide both sides by a, and I'm going to get t equals v minus v naught over a. Is that right? I think it's okay. Now I'm going to take this equation in blue. This is where it came from. But where is it going to go? Let's show where it's going to go in green. It's going to go into here and into here. So this is a derivation. We are deriving a new equation from two things that you trust. If you don't trust these two things, then you're going to have to go back and watch some earlier videos. But if you trust these two, I'm going to give you a new equation. And the beautiful thing... The beautiful thing about taking this equation and solving it for t and plugging it into this equation where the t is the t's will be gone. So let's see what happens. We're going to get delta x on that left side. Delta x, now this is coming down to here with the new plugged in business. Delta x equals v naught times all that stuff right there, which is v minus v naught over a. And then I have to go to this next term, which says 1/2 a times, now that stuff squared. I'm going to go ahead and square that stuff right now. In the denominator, I get a square. In the numerator, I'm going to get, oh gosh, I got to FOIL that stuff, binomial expansion or some nonsense. I'm going to get that square, the square. And then I'm going to subtract 2. That's a square there. I'm going to get 2 v v naught, right? That's the cross term. And then I also have to add on v naught square. Okay, so I've got all of this stuff and it's a mess. It's kind of gross. I think, my gut reaction here is that we can use the color of blood to cancel things, a and the a square in the denominator right there. I don't see anything else immediately that cancels. So my next plan is going to be to multiply everything by 2a. So here is a 2a, here is a 2a, and here is a 2a. All right, so this a right here, let's cancel some a's. That a cancels that a, and this a that's left in the denominator cancels that a right there, and that 2 is canceled by that 2 right there. Now on my next line I get 2 times a times delta x equals... what's left over here? 2v v naught, 2v naught v, that's the order there in v naught v, I'll try not to be confusing, minus, oh shoot, minus 2v naught square, that's both from this term, and then I get, let's see, all of that stuff is all dead, I just get plus v square minus 2v v naught plus v naught square. Interestingly, there are some things going on here. What are you noticing? Are you noticing that by the commutativity principle, this term and this term are the same thing but opposites, so they both cancel? I agree, I agree. And also, this says take away two of those and then add one more back. So when it all is said and done, I get 2 times a times delta x equals, let's see, we said we'd get one of these, but it'd be negative. So I'm going to write the v square and then subtract the v naught square. And I'm going to add this v naught square to both sides, and I'm going to switch the order of the two sides so that I get my final result. This is v square equals v naught square plus 2a delta x. And I call this guy a tale of two squares. See if you can figure out why. It's a literary reference, that's why. And notice this equation has no time. So it's an equation for when you're in a hurry. If you don't have the time!